we shall learn the saptavimshatihi nakshatrani. Okay, so far we had seen panchadasha tithayah up till 15, number 15. The last part of it is saptavimshatihi nakshatrani. We shall learn this today. So I shall call out one of the students and Shriram Venkatesh.
Namaste, sir.
Namaste. Can you please read out the words? Saptavimshatihi nakshatrani.
Saptavimshatihi nakshatrani. Ashwini. Bharani. Tutika. Rohini. Mrigashirsham. Ardra. Punarvasu.
Pushya. Punarvasu. Dirgha is there.
Pushya. Ashesha. Magha. पूर्व फल्गुनी उत्तर फल्गुनी हस्त है चित्रा स्वाति विशाखा अनुराधा ज्येष्ठा मूलम पूर्वाषाढ़ा उत्तराषाढ़ा श्रवण है धनिष्ठा शतभिषक पूर्व पूर्वा भाद्रा उत्तरा भाद्रा रेवती
उत्तमम वेल रिसाइटेड उत्तमम वेल रिसाइटेड धन्यवादाः सो अश्विनी भरणी इत्यादि दीस आर द 27 नक्षत्रास नेम्स ऑफ द 27 स्टार्स सप्तविंशतिः नक्षत्राणि नक्षत्रम इज अ नपुंसकलिंग शब्द एंड हेंस नक्षत्राणि इज बहुवचन ऑफ दैट ओके So Ashwini to Revati, these 27 nakshatras will have to memorize in the same order. Okay, please memorize. Start memorizing these in the same order, because in the exam they will also ask write 10 nakshatras starting from Swatihi, write 10 nakshatras starting from Ardra or anything. So they can ask anywhere from anywhere to write the next 10 nakshatras. So we'll have to remember all these 27 nakshatras. Okay. So please practice this, so that will be useful and only and also this will be these are some of our traditional elements, right? So as part of our tradition, in earlier days at least, the grandparents used to teach the kids in the, during the evening times all these names of the different tithis, names of the nakshatras, names of the samvatsaras. So 60 samvatsaras are there, shashti samvatsaraha. So earlier in the previous syllabus of Prathama, we had to also learn the names of the 60 samvatsaras. Okay, but in the new syllabus, that is not part of it. So, but these are some of the things which if we learn, it is good, because these are traditional aspects of our culture and very important things that we should know and we should also pass on to the next generations. So please try to practice this. And the easy technique is to just keep on reading and record in your own voice. First thing, record and keep listening to your own voice. So that way you'll be able to grasp it and also recollect and memorize it faster. Okay. So all these portions of memorization have been uploaded already onto the course page. So I think if you remember, if you go to the exam corner, there is an audio file also associated with it. So you'll be able to practice that. Okay. Now let us quickly see all the numbers which we have seen earlier also. I'm just showing this again so that you can revise. So ekam to dasha, vimshatihi, trimshat, chatvarimshat, etc. And then how these numbers are there with respect to dvichatvarimshat, trichatvarimshat, chatushchatvarimshat, panchachatvarimshat, etc. What is the prefix for each of these? Eka, dvi, tri, chatur, pancha, shat, sapta, ashta, nava. Okay, in this way, remember these numbers also, practice these numbers, so that will be helpful. Now, moving forward, we will try to do the exercises here. Okay, now I shall unmute some of you and then we will see that. Pragya Bhatt, Kalyan Mohodaya, Shailaja Gunda, and Padma Narayan. So I have unmuted four of you. So we will do one by one. So for the first four questions, Or first, okay, first four questions, Pragya would ask the question, and Kalyan Mahalaya would answer. The next four questions, Shailaja Bhagini would ask the question, and Padma Bhagini would answer. Or you can switch roles in between. Yeah, Pragya Bhagini, you can ask.
Mahoday. Vachanani kani.
Vachanani.
Okay.
Ekavachanam, ekavachanam, dvibachanam, bahuvachanam.
Right. That's it. That is the answer. Though this is not part of the exact, this is not there in the text that we have seen, but vachanam is something which we have learned already. Vachanani trini, tani. Okay. So kati is not being asked. How many they have not asked. So trini vachanani, you can put a hyphen and write the answer. Ekavachanam, dvivachanam, and bahuvachanam.
Yes.
Yes. Now you can ask the question.
Pancha bhutani kani.
Pancha bhutani. Jalam vayuhu akashah bhumihi agnihi.
Very good. So the five bhutas or the gross elements, five gross elements is what we have seen that. Okay. Next question.
Shad ritavah ke.
Sorry, I haven't memorized this.
Okay, so this was not, yeah, this is not part of basically part of this text actually. This was part of the previous syllabus actually. Somehow some of the questions have been added, or these are all some of the general knowledge questions, so which can be asked also. We can think in that way. Yes, sure. Anyone here would like to answer, either Pragya, Shailaja, or Padma Bhagini?
Vasanta rutuhu, Grishma rutuhu, Varsha rutuhu, Sharat rutuhu, Hemanta rutuhu, Shishira rutuhu.
Very good. So these are the six rutus which are there for, corresponding to the 12 months actually. So Chaitra, Vaishakha, Jyeshtha, etc. The 12 months, Dwadasha Masaha. Again, that is not part of what we have learned so far. Dwadasha Rashiha only we have learned. So each rutu will be for 2 months basically. For 2 months, it is classified as a rutu. Okay. So, Shad Ritavaha Santi, and these are the Shad Rutus which Pragya Bhagini mentioned. Okay. Next, we should go to the next question. Kalyan Mohade, you can ask the question.
Ashtadikpalakaha ke.
Ashtadikpalakaha Indraha Agnihi Yamaha Nirratihi Varunaha Vayuhu Kuberaha Ishanaha.
Very good, very good. So that is present in the textbook itself in the previous pages. The Ashta Dikpalakaha, the outer circle, whatever is there. So those are the Dikpalakas. You can start from Purva, basically from the east, which is Indraha, Agnihi, Vayu, Yamaha, Nirratihi, Varunaha, Vayuhu, Kuberaha, Ishanaha. So in the same order, in the cyclic order, we can tell that. Okay, dhanyavadaha Pragya Bhagini and Kalyan Mohadaya, well participated and well answered.
Dhanyavadaha.
Shailaja Bhagini and Padma Bhagini, you can ask the next set of questions.
Navagraha ke.
We don't have Navagraha. Yes, we don't have Navagraha, but can you answer? Because this is again a general knowledge question, you can think that way.
Samrahu, Ketu, Surya,
yes.
Chandra. And
yes,
then Guru, Shukran, Shani.
That's right. So these are Navagraha. Yes. So basically, Surya, if you remember one shloka, Suryaya, Chandraya, Mangalaya, Budhaya, cha, Guru, Shukra, Shani, Bhashta, Rahu.
Yeah. Rahu,
okay.
Ketu. Yeah.
Yeah. Whenever we go to any temple, we go to the Navagraha deity.
Yes.
And then we
yes.
do the pradakshinam. So this is the shloka usually chanted. So you can remember and you can answer it. Okay. But anyway, I shall give the post answers for these questions anyway in the course page. So, but yeah, Navagraha. Okay. Next, you can ask the question. Dasha avataraha ke.
Dasha avataraha ke.
Ramaha, Krishnaha.
Starting from, let it be in the order. Okay. Let it be in the order. So I shall flash that screen. Dasha avataraha, Matsya Kurva Varaha Narasimha. So let it be in the order. So whenever
okay.
you answer.
Okay. Matsyaha, Kurmaha, Varahaha, Narasimhaha, Vamanaha, Parashuramaha, Shriramaha, श्रीकृष्णः
बुद्धः
कल्किः
यस दैट्स राइट ओके नेक्स्ट दशावताराः इज ओवर नेक्स्ट वन षड्रसाः के
षड्रसाः के
ओके षड्रसाः आई हैव इट हियर ओके निंद्रा तंद्रा भय इज दैट राइट नो नो सॉरी
मधुरः
षड्रसाः मधुरः तिक्तः कटुः आम्लः कषायः लवणम्
राइट सो दोस आर द षड्रसाः वेरी गुड हातव्याः दोषाः के So for that, whatever answer you started with,
Nindra, yeah. Tandra. Nindra, Tandra, Bhayam, Krodaha, Alasyam, Dirgas,
Sutrata.
How do you say the Dirga Sutrata?
Sutrata. Yes, that's right.
Dirga Sutrata.
Right. Rashayaha ke, Dvadasha Rashayaha. So that is known. Amesha, Vrishabha, etc. The 12 Rashis. I think you will be able to write that. And Chitta Nakshatra Darabhya, Dasha Nakshatranam Namani Likhata. This is exactly what we have learned in today's class. So from Chitta Nakshatra, so identify
Chitra,
where.
Yes. Chitra, Swatihi, Vishakaha, Anuradha, Jeshtaha, Moolam, Purvashada, Uttarashada, Shravanam, Dhanishtha.
Shravanaha, Dhanishtha, and Chitavashita. So the okay, 10 nakshatras we will have to identify.
Yeah.
Okay. So practice. That's why the memorization of nakshatra names is important. So please do practice it. And the next main is Vijatiyam Padam Likhata, right? The odd men out. Okay. So I think this is easier with respect to like, there is one set of words. For example, Meshaha, Mithunam and Simhaha all belong to Rashis, but Ashwini is a Nakshatra. So you will be able to identify this. So I'm just going quickly because I have to make one important announcement. So I'm just telling it quickly. And similarly, Navami, Ekadashi, Indraha, Purnima, again, the three are the tithis. Is the odd man out. Then Kashyapaha, Gautamaha, Niruratihi, Vasishtaha.
Niruratihi.
Rishis and one more is Niruratihi, which Nirurati. Is the direction. Next, Bhakshyam, Bhojyam, Lekhyam, Saumyaha.
Saumyaha.
Bhakshyam, Bhojyam, Lekhyam, Choshyam. These are the four different varieties of eatables. But Saumyaha is basically Buddhaha, basically which is Navagraha, one of the Navagrahas. And then Akasham, Pavakaha, Bhutalam, Moolam.
Pavakaha.
Mm-hmm.
Moolam.
Yes, that is Moolam. Because Akasham, Pavakaha, Bhutalam are part of Pancha Bhutani. Bhutalam is same as nothing but Bhumihi. Okay. So Moolam is a Nakshatram. Moolam is name of one of the Nakshatram. So identify it clearly so that there'll be no mistake because let us not lose any marks. Though we know it, but because of silly mistakes, let us not lose marks. Okay.
What does Pavakaha mean, sir?
Pavakaha is fire. Agnihi, Pavakaha. Both are same. Okay. So that is with respect to the exercise for this Sankhyaha. This part is clear, I guess. So I shall share the next important announcement. Please stay for a few seconds. I will share that. There are two important announcements. So please pay attention and please focus on these announcements. So one is, the first one is intermediate assessment scores have been released for everyone. Okay, already it was released on Tuesday itself. So check for the mail if you have not found it. Okay, check for the mail from vyomasamskritapathashala@gmail.com. You can search in your Gmail folders and with subject either with the subject at least like score released SSS Prathama intermediate assessment etc. So you can search with SSS Prathama as the search string. Please check in either of updates, promotions or spam folders, and it can be any of one of this. So usually it will be there in updates for most of us, but if it is classified, the mails are classified as promotion etc., it would be there in promotions folder. So it easier would be to search for SSS Prathama string in your mailbox so that you'll be able to see the scores of the first part, that is objective type. Okay. And there also you can, if you click on view, you'll be able to go to that page and see what, which all answers were correct. And for the wrong answers, it would have been mentioned which is the correct answer. Okay. Next, another important announcement. So I had told SSS related to the SSS Prathama exam, by last week of July, we'll be getting more details. So I had a conversation with a director of Sabha yesterday, and most of the things are getting finalized, and the last date to fill the application form is extended till mid of August. So they are working on making the exam online, and it is in the final rounds of review. So further details would be available by 10th of August. So kindly have patience with respect to the exam related queries. So don't worry, and Suresh sir has assured that don't worry about the last date for the filing or filling the application form. So it will be made in the system itself, and there'll be no issues for registering for the course, for the exam, etc. So yeah, further details are yet to be known. So please have patience until mid of August. Okay, so we will be able to give more details by then. And next is kindly do not call Sabha or Vyoma office or email me, etc. with respect to the exam related queries. So these were the two important announcements that I wanted to make. One more important thing, I think I had shared this also in the earlier part. So in the previous classes as well. So basically, like, there are a few resources that you can make use of to learn along with this. So it is just like a complementary learning so that you will be able to learn faster and also learn more things which are related to these aspects. One is definitely Dhatu Rupa and Shabda Rupa. Please keep practicing Shabdas and Dhatus. It is very important. And then vocabulary, to build your vocabulary in Sanskritum, you can refer to this book, which is Sanskrit Vocabulary Builder. And similarly for dictionaries, there are a few dictionaries which are there online. There are many more actually. LearnSanskrit.cc, Ashtadhyayi.com and Kosha.Sanskrit.today. Please make use of these resources which are available online for your learning. Let these be your companion for learning. And of course, for verb forms and to practice, etc., I've shared these links. These are part of your part of the PDFs that I upload to the course page. So please use these resources and learn. And also to learn sandhis and to practice more exercises, etc., there is a beautiful app which has been created by Vyoma Labs itself, which is available both for iOS and Android. The name of the app itself is Sandhi app. You can download that. If you don't know like where it is available, etc., if you visit this website, digitalsanskritguru.com website, then you'll be able to find it out. There is one section wherein all the mobile apps are listed. So the Sandhi app will be very useful to read the concept that we have learned today, at least focus on the Swara Sandhis and what we have learned. There are also exercises that you can do, and you'll be able to learn through that as well. So if you come to M Learning, which is there, mobile learning basically, you'll be able to find out all the apps that are available. And quickly I'll show that. So the free apps which are there, so you can use them to learn. So to learn Sanskrit alphabet, etc., all these things are there. In the same way, if you go to next, Sandhi is the app, 16th, it is listed in the 16th. Just clicking on this link, you will be able to download please practice it. This will be a very good companion for you to learn other Sandhis also, which are not covered as part of Prathama syllabus. Okay. So these are some of the announcements which I wanted to make. And right now in the Prathama course page, I have put one section as announcements. Okay. If there are any important announcements, etc., those will be getting updated in this page itself, in the top right corner of the course page. So there will be no emails relating to either assessment, assignment, etc. I shall announce in the class. And of course, in this announcements section, I will put up those details. Okay. So please keep referring to the course page so that you will be updated with the latest information that are needed. So these are some of the things which I wanted to tell. I think it's already time. I will take up a few question and answers now. I shall lower everyone's hands now. And if you have any questions, please raise your hand. Okay.